Hey everyone, how's it going? Welcome back to Chef Vic Cuisine. Today, we're making candy cane sugar cookies. Now, this is a perfect recipe for the holiday season, and I hope you guys enjoy it as much as I do. So, let's get started.
All right, so for the ingredients, you're gonna need half a cup of shortening at room temperature, half a cup of unsalted butter at room temperature, 1 cup of powdered sugar that you're gonna sift, 1 egg at room temperature, 1.5 teaspoons of almond extract, 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract, 2 cups of all-purpose flour that's sifted, 1 teaspoon of salt, and finally 1/2 teaspoon of red food coloring, plus some additional for color intensity. All right, so to get things started, you're gonna preheat your oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 176 degrees Celsius. And then you wanna add your room temperature shortening and butter to a large bowl of a stand mixer. I use a paddle attachment, and what you wanna do is beat the butter and shortening together until it's all well combined and creamy. You're looking for this type of texture for that combination. Following that, you want to sift the powdered sugar on top of this combined shortening and butter. Don't forget to smash that like button, share this video, and subscribe to this channel. And stay tuned to the end of this video for a sneak peek of the recipe coming next week. Once you've sifted through all the powdered sugar, you want to add your 1 egg and then mix all of that together until it's all well combined. While the sugar, the egg, the shortening and the butter are mixing together, you want to go ahead and drop in your almond extract and your vanilla extract to the mix. This is what the texture should look like of the resulting mixture. Now, separately in a smaller bowl, you want to mix together the sifted flour and the salt. And just make sure the salt is well mixed into the sifted flour. Now with your new combined dry ingredients, you want to slowly add the dry mixture into your wet mixture. So I reuse the paddle attachment and I add about 1/4 portion of the dry ingredients at a time, making sure that the dry mixture I add to the wet mixture has enough time to incorporate before adding the next 1/4 portion of the dry ingredients. So once you've added all of the dry ingredients, you should have a resulting dough. Now what I like to do is double back with a rubber spatula and just go ahead and scrape down the sides and the bottom of the bowl, because stand mixers are kind of finicky when it comes to thoroughly mixing all the ingredients, especially around the sides and the bottom. So go ahead and knock off the sides of the dough from the bowl and then go ahead and give that a mix again. It shouldn't mix for too long. It's just to make sure that all the missing flour that wasn't incorporated gets used in forming the dough. So now you have the dough that you're going to use for making the cookies. It has a texture similar to Play-Doh or clay. It shouldn't be too sticky. And what you want to do is divide the total amount of dough in half. 1/2 of the dough will be for the red food coloring, and the other 1/2 of the dough will be for the white portion of the candy cane. So go ahead and set the white portion of the dough aside. And for the 1/2 of the dough that you're going to use for the red food coloring, what I like to do is make a small indentation on the surface of the dough and then add the red food coloring into that. And then what you want to do is go ahead and attach your paddle attachment again to the stand mixer and mix that dough until the red food coloring is well incorporated. So after the first mix, you just want to take your paddle attachment off and then go ahead and go back with a rubber spatula to scrape down the sides of the bowl and the bottom of the bowl again, because the red food coloring normally doesn't incorporate as well as you think it did, and some of the white parts of the dough are still present. So once you've scraped down all the sides of the bowl, just go ahead and give that dough another mix, and that should be enough to make sure that all the dough is completely red. Oh, and a really great tip for working with these cookies is if you have them available to you, I would use some powder-free gloves. Red food coloring can really stain your skin, and so to avoid that, just use some powder-free gloves while working with this dessert. So for preparing the cookies, what you want to do is lightly flour a working surface, and then take 1 tablespoon of the white dough and 1 tablespoon of the red dough. And what you want to do is roll out those tablespoons of dough into 4 to 5 inch long strips. The red and the white strips of dough should be of equal length. And I find the best way to roll the dough is between your hands. So once you have both strips of dough, you want to carefully twist them about themselves until you have that candy cane pattern. Then you want to curve the top of the cookie to look like the shape of a candy cane. And then just carefully place the cookie onto a parchment paper lined baking sheet. And then you just want to repeat the same steps for the remaining dough. And this should end up resulting in about a dozen candy cane cookies. And just a word of note, you just want to always be careful with handling this dough. It can be pretty fragile, so always press down any resulting cracks that you might see while you're forming the dough, and take extra care while handling the dough, especially while transferring it between the working surface and the baking sheet. Once you have all the cookie dough formed, you want to bake these cookies at 350 degrees Fahrenheit or 176 degrees Celsius for about 8 to 9 minutes or until the white part of the dough has slightly browned. Once the time is up, you want to remove them from the oven and then just set them aside to cool on the baking sheet for about an additional 10 minutes and then you can serve and enjoy. And just like that, you made your very own candy cane sugar cookies. These are a perfect dessert for those winter months, and especially for those looking for holiday-specific treats. They have a super delicate texture and a lot of flavor, and they melt in your mouth, and I know you guys will enjoy them just as much as I do. And for a variation of this recipe, try adding a teaspoon of mint extract to the red food-colored dough for a new twist on this cookie. As always, this recipe and many more can be found in my cookbook, Chef Vic Cuisine, Volume 1, Finding Your Inner Chef, and that's available on Amazon, and I'll be sure to leave a link to that in the description box. Thank you all for watching. Don't forget to smash that like button, subscribe to this channel, and stay tuned for next week where I show you to make this amazing sweet corn soup. It packs a ton of heat, and it's perfect for this time of year. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time on another episode of Chef Vic Cuisine. And until then, peace.